devices into the vehicle and integrating with them seamlessly using voice control. So it starts in the center console. I have two USB ports for my portable media player and music on a USB thumb drive. We also use the USB ports for software updates because the system is upgradable all the time. We also have an SD card slot for navigation map software. And we have three RCA jacks for audio and video. And video, of course, only when the vehicle's in park. And the MyFord touch system really starts with the touchscreen in the center stack. 8-inch display. I can customize it by uploading a photo from USB. That's a picture of my son. This is the few options. Each of the four color corners are color-coded. So we have entertainment, phone, navigation, and climate control. So if I start with entertainment, anytime I bring in my iPod, for example, all my music is stored on my iPod, and I can see that the album cover artwork is transferred directly from the screen. You can see it on the screen. And instead of reaching down to my device and fumbling and looking for the music that I want to find, I can use voice controls to say play artist, Coldplay, play album, play genre, play playlist. Any of the content that's stored in my media player, I can use voice commands to access. Similar with phone. Every time I come into the car with my Bluetooth-enabled mobile phone, the phone book automatically downloads and transfers. And then instead of going to my phone to call a contact, I can, let's call my wife.
Please say a command.
Call Aisha, my wife.
Calling Aisha, my wife, on cell.
So if any of the phone book contacts, I can call just using the simple voice command. We'll welcome the call. It's not her real number. Otherwise, she'd be upset with all the phone calls. If she sends me an SMS text message, for the phones that support it, instead of reaching out to the phone with the SMS, Sync will be the SMS message back to me. But the real power of voice control, you can see in navigation. So the navigation, I mentioned the software, mapped data is stored on the SD card. You can see, simulating we're in Washington, D.C., and there's the U.S. Capitol. And I want to route to a street address.
Please say a command.
Find the street address.
District of Columbia. Say the street address including the city.
1600 Pennsylvania Avenue Northwest, Washington.
When ready, press the voice button and then say set as destination or say change something.
Set as destination, then I'm ready to go. So you really, now we're using voice control. It's starting to become the primary interface in the car to minimize driver distraction. Another great innovation of Sync is our emergency assistance feature. So if I happen to be in an accident and an airbag deploys, using the connected mobile phone, Sync will call emergency assistance, emergency services directly. No subscription fee, free for the lifetime of customers. Since we're using the existing infrastructure, we're able to support more than 30 countries. So Sync will expand and grow over time in the future. So since it's upgradable, we're using the USB port. Example of that is Apple, where we voice control the Apple features on our smartphones. That's another feature. And we've also launched the US that we're getting into Europe. So we've announced Sync in the Ford V Max. Sync with my Ford Touch will come to Focus Electric and then the all new Lightning. Okay. So great. Thank you for your time. If you have any questions afterwards, please.